So what is autonomy? Big question, right? So you ask probably six people, you might get 12 answers. But for us, and depending on your background too, right? For some people, it's, look, wow, this is really novel. No one's ever done this before. Like, this is a new paradigm in aviation. For other people, it's, what are you talking about? We've been flying unpiloted drones for decades. Commercial aircraft today, the pilot's hardly touching any controls. So what's the big deal, right? Well, you're both right. For reference, 93% of the pilot functions today in a commercial airliner are already performed by a computer. And autonomy for us is really about taking that a step further. So we're starting with those same proven technologies that you would find in an aircraft today. We're talking flight control systems, flight management systems, navigation systems. And we're adding to that proprietary logic and algorithms and additional sensing capabilities to create an even a more automated system with predictable deterministic outcomes. And I emphasize that predictability because we talked about certification and how that's really important for us. You know, the determinism of the software and the behavior of the vehicle, right, and that explainability is crucial to our success in certification. And that's really what separates us from a lot of the autonomous vehicles that have existed until now. So that's really important. And by making the aircraft and its autonomous systems responsible for those higher frequency, more time-sensitive tasks, we free up that human operator to focus on the more complex, lower frequency tasks. It's important to note, I mean, it's been mentioned several times, but remember that the human is involved, right? The human has the ability to command the aircraft, but largely, the aircraft will make the decisions and intervene as necessary to keep the system and the passenger safe. So another way to look at this, especially if you come from a piloting background like I do, you're training, right? We're programming an automated system to do the type of things that a pilot would do, but more thoroughly, right? Because by designing that behavior, we're building in that experience, the knowledge from pilots and engineers, from decades of experience from our Boeing, Aurora, Wisk partners, and we're able to consider all those scenarios from the beginning, program in the correct response, which ensures that it's gonna do the right thing every time, versus relying on a person to make a decision or recall the correct procedure in the heat of the moment. And critically, this is all done at scale. I think it's been mentioned several times. Scale is critical to us, right? And this to do that, we have to do what we call one-to-many oversight. What does that mean? It means one operator is able to control multiple aircraft simultaneously. And so while Wisk is one of the only companies pursuing that self-flying first approach, pretty much we realize, and I think the whole industry realizes, that autonomy is critical to scale. And so that's why the work that we're doing here, the success that we're talking about, it's not just about the success of our own company, it's really about the success of the whole industry. So now I'm gonna take a little bit of time to focus on some of the cutting edge technology and some of the activity that the team has already been working on thus far. So what you're looking at here is a simulation, looking at how our autonomous system might navigate the airspace. And in this case, it's in Honolulu, Hawaii, with some restricted airspace there, probably the Pearl Harbor Naval Base. We've already proven, right? You've seen today our flight. We've already proven that we can fly an aircraft autonomously. But that's in a test scenario, right? To achieve the scale that so many are talking about, we have to find a way to integrate our services safely into the national airspace system. And we have to solve that problem before anyone can meaningfully start services. So this look into airspace operations and how we integrate into the airspace is really critical to our success too, right? It's not just about the technology. What else? We're working really closely with a Boeing partner in situ on some of the detect and avoid technologies that enable these autonomous operations. So what you're seeing here is some testing that in situ did between an autonomous aircraft, one of their smaller autonomous vehicles, and these pilots that are flying a general aviation aircraft. And what they're doing is they're testing enhanced detection capabilities, in this case using onboard radars. So the idea, right, is the technology is designed to enhance the ability to safely integrate these autonomous aircraft into the airspace system, because as many of you know, detect and avoid is one of the key functions that's required by a pilot today in order to integrate into the national airspace system. And I wanted to point it out, by the way, that in most of these encounters, the system actually detected the other aircraft in the distance well before the pilot ever saw it. And in many cases, the pilot never saw the other aircraft. And it kind of, anyone who's actually flown in busy airspace as a pilot here can appreciate how hard it is to spot traffic, even when you have ATC telling you look in that direction, right? And so the technologies can really help us get over some of those barriers to limitations on human performance. And so we're, what we're doing is we're leveraging these kind of results to inform and validate our design, right? These help accelerate some of the technologies that we're looking at and improve the way that we're building our vehicle. And this also demonstrates the excellent collaboration that we have across the Boeing enterprise, and we're really fortunate to have their support in this area. And speaking of partners, we're also working with SkyGrid to bring some of the aerospace information and services into our system, right? And the idea there is that will further enhance our situational awareness, which ultimately, at the end of the day, makes things safer. The more information that we have, both in ground and airborne systems, the smarter our aircraft can be. What else? So this is actually, we've been keeping our sights on some of the newer capabilities and technologies in the space as well. These are some results from tests that we performed here in Hollister last year using a visual-based traffic spotting system by a company called Dedalion. So we did encounters between two Wisk GA-sized aircraft to measure how well the system performed in terms of spotting. And we also tested some of the technology that they have to support navigation, so being able to lose GPS and still navigate safely, which is really critical for autonomous operations. And so while we recognize novel technologies like this present challenges to certification, regulators have shown some encouraging engagement in this area. There's a lot of activity in working groups and you know, in FAA is showing up to a lot of these events and giving input about how some of these technologies might actually play out. So it's really exciting to see that progress. And so we're going to continue evaluating these and making sure that we're picking the best technologies for our system. Also, I think it's pretty obvious to anyone that's done development of these kind of technologies, our autonomous approach demands a lot of testing, a lot of data, right? It's a lot of integration of sensors, software, in various types of environments and conditions. And so, as you can imagine, it's impractical to test a lot of these in the real world. There's a lot of dangers associated with some of the potential encounters that you might generate, like even this. And so we're supplementing our flight test with high fidelity simulation software. And in this clip, you're seeing us use a tool from Siemens. And so this allows us to understand how certain aspects of the technology and the aircraft will perform in real world scenarios that are very difficult to produce. And so at the end of the day, you know, we can also test, like if we upgrade hardware, we have a more performant sensor, we make changes to the software, boom, run the test again, and do it in a wide variety of real world scenarios. So really powerful, and given that there's no really precedent for these operations today, being able to generate lots of data and to convince the regulator that this is going to work is really important. So the volume of data that we can collect and the learnings that we can get from this are really powerful. And I think it really is a fundamental change, especially for aviation. It really is going to change the way these things fly. And really what we're talking about is if we actually pull this off, which we will, I mean, that's Collier Trophy material right there, right? Like, we can do that. So it's really exciting.